Welcome to your life. We don't have your back. Even while you sleep, you will find us acting on our worst behavior, blaming you and Mother Nature. We don't really want to save the world. It's all by design. We don't feel remorse. Your future we despise. Heaven help us. Granted number fives for nature, but we're all too scared to face her. We don't really want to save the world. We got the power, so light won't blind you. Holding hands while the walls come tumbling down. We got the gas and we got the cold too. No one to save our nations. We're here for corporations. We don't really want to save the world.
You're watching The Hughes at 10 with me, the sexy Hugh Edwards. A man who's too sexy for his shirt, it hurts. Following the Owen Paterson lobbying scandal, Labour frontbencher Thangam Debonair has called on Prime Minister Boris Johnson and Leader of the House of Commons Jacob Rees-Mogg to consider their positions. In reply, Mr. Johnson said that after careful consideration, he would stick with the sitting position, while Mr. Rees-Mogg said he preferred lying down. A millionaire in Spain was mugged of Bitcoin worth millions of euros after armed criminals broke into his home and forced him to reveal his passwords. This was the second time he'd been robbed after being sold Bitcoin in the first place.
Oh, how do, Jeff? How do, Jeff? Out interesting into paper. Oh, just, you know, the reek nonsense about us at Yorkshire Cricket Club being a bunch of racists who were stuck in past. Aye, proper load of nonsense, is that a no mistake? Anyway, what was it you wanted to see me about then, Jeff? Aye, right. Well, Jeff, I reckon it's time we organised a club Christmas party. Oh, aye, you're not wrong there, Jeff. So, what do you want to do this year? Well, Jeff, I reckon we should have a 1970s themed party. Aye, sounds reek grand, that does. I can't see any reason to break with tradition. Aye. We've been having a 1970s themed Christmas party every year since, well, I reckon since 1980. Aye, happen as not. So, I reckon, to get everyone into mood, we'll start off as usual with the screening of the first six episodes of the classic sitcom Love Thy Neighbour. Oh, grand idea that, Jeff. Always goes down a retreat. Aye. And then we'll follow that up as usual with an episode of the Black and White Minstrel Show. Oh, that'll be reet grand. I'll just look forward to that every year. And then, before we have the buffet and the disco, we'll finish off to screenings as usual with Wheel Tappers and Shunters Social Club. Reek grand again, Jeff. Right, so what about buffet? Same as usual. Aye, Jeff. Ham sandwiches, cheese sandwiches and pork pies. None of that foreign muck like onion barges and samosas. Reek you are, Jeff. Oh, and as usual, now put proper Yorkshire ale to drink. Grand. Reek then, Jeff. That just leaves to disco and getting to Christmas tree. Right. Well, with all this stuff about climate change and environment going on, I reckon we should just have a small tree and make sure it's from a sustainable forest and no lights on tree or with disco to reduce our carbon footprint. Right you are, Jeff. After all, it's important that we make sure that we move with times. Happen as like. Chuff.
Thank you. Is it? Are they? Ah, yes, I'm here. My fellow Americans, as you can see, I'm speaking to you from Glasgow. And I've been picking up some of the local patter. I love Glasgow. And not enough to stay there, of course. I'm staying in Edinburgh, which has got more castles and less soccer-related violence. My local translator, Wee Shug, says he's going to take me out tonight for the full Glaswegian experience. We're going to get a chippy and some iron brew, go up the dancing, and head back to an MT for birds and swagers. I have no idea what any of it means, but it sounds great. Now, I've not been dancing in a while, but I can still do a mean Charleston. Oh, whoa, would you look at that. I'm booked in to get yelled at by Greta Thunberg in 10 minutes, so I'd better get going. As they say around here, cheery bye, you bampots.
Hello, my love, it's me, your Auntie Vax. Did you have a spooky Halloween?
I hope not, because the whole thing is run by Satanists to rope the innocent into taking part in their devil worship rituals. But toffee apples are good, aren't they? Makes it all worth it. Anyway, that means it's just 44 sleeps till Christmas, which brings me to my first letter. Dear Auntie Vax, I was so excited to see that Heinz were releasing a special canned Christmas dinner, full of turkey, pigs in blankets, stuffing and sprouts, all in a can. But it sold out as soon as it went on sale. Is this part of a sinister conspiracy to cancel Christmas? Yours, Festive in Furl. Well, Festive, don't get your stocking in a twist. There's no conspiracy about the Heinz tin Christmas dinner selling out. It was me! I bought all of them for my doomsday bunker. See, the way I see it, once the world ends, I'm going to be in that bunker for who knows how long. So I'll need these cans to keep me in Christmas dinners for the entire post-apocalypse. Maybe should have been a bit quicker off the mark. I was refreshing the Heinz website for 30 seconds for 2 days to get in early enough. Still, look on the bright side. Nuclear winter means we'll get lots and lots of white Christmases.
British Airways has apologised after passengers receiving crates of frozen fish on a baggage carousel instead of their luggage. To make matters worse, their suitcases are on a fishing boat seized by the French Navy.
Elizabeth told to give up drinking, she's downbeat. No more boozing from now on, oh, that's what she's been told. Now she must swear that the alcohol she will forego. She's sober now and dismayed and grumpy, so I'm told. Has she really given up the gin? Will there really be no Dubonnet tonight? Has she really given up the gin from now on? It's soft drink strictly, she's not even allowed a small beer. Now every night she would drink gin and Dubonnet's a treat. Sit in her chair and enjoy the taste of that vermouth. She also cared for Martini, and she'd often tend to have a glass of wine for lunch, sometimes even food. How's she coping now without the gin? How's she coping with a Dubonnet at night? Maybe being sober she will binge, she's not amused. So Her Majesty, back to us the booze she might be a. She might be a.
mentioned it once, I think I got away with it. Oh. Good evening, citizens of Britain, and indeed, the world. It is time to get serious about climate change. We must act now in metaphysical terms. It is 1 minute to midnight, and we must get our mistress dressed and out of the bedroom window before the wife gets home. We are, if you will, a bit like James Bond, saving the world and bonking as much totty as possible along the way. But words are easy, and it's our actions upon which we shall be judged. You probably read in the papers about how my current wife, Carrie, is doing her bit. Now, what a fine bit she is. Now, reducing her carbon footprint by wearing the same jacket to a staggering two separate events. Inspired by this gesture, I myself slept with the same woman twice last week and wore the same pair of underpants on both occasions, which is terrific. But my heroic and selfless actions don't stop there. You may be aware that fridges contribute to climate change because they emit high levels of carbon dioxide. Therefore, in future, when the press are trying to ask me difficult questions, I vow to hide only in fully sustainable containers such as wooden cupboards. Yeah. And when I'm telling outrageous lies to the British public, I will no longer use polluting red buses, but instead use more environmentally friendly vehicles such as BBC News political editors. I will also initiate a weekly clap for the climate event, where people will be encouraged to stand on their doorsteps at 8 o'clock on a Thursday, banging their pots and pans together to make global temperatures stabilise, which would be terrific fun. Now, of course, COP26 won't mark the end of climate change, but it can and it must mark the beginning of a series of fruitless discussions which will result in no concrete action and which will be continued next year at COP27, when the climate situation has grown even worse. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm off to clean up Glasgow streets by collecting a load of uncollected rubbish and throwing it on a massive bonfire. Eat your heart out, Thunberg. Terrific.
Oh, hello. Yes, delighted to meet you. I'm Prince Charles, and you are?
Leonardo DiCaprio, Your Highness.
Oh, I see. What do you do?
Well, I'm an actor, Your Highness.
Oh, splendid. Haven't been anything big at all?
Well, I guess I'm best known for being in Titanic.
Wow, being on the Titanic. Good Lord, that must have been dreadful. Dreadful ordeal. Mind you, you don't look nearly old enough. You have work done. You have Botox.
No, Your Highness. I wasn't actually on the Titanic. I was in the movie Titanic.
Oh, right. A film. Yes. I can't say I've seen it. More of a theatre opera myself. Well, what was the one with Sean Connery? The Man Who Would Be King. Yeah, I've seen that lots of times. Yeah.
So you don't watch many movies, Your Highness?
No, no. One normally prefers a good book, you know. Big fan of an American author chap, in fact. Stephen King? Yes. Splendid surname, King. King, yes, splendid. Yes. So, anyway, I'm sure you were absolutely splendid in... what was it again?
Titanic, Your Highness. Anyway, I must say, I'm pleased to see you here at this summit. I understand you've been interested in the environment for a long time.
Oh, yes, that's right. One's been banging on about it since the 1970s. But back then, people thought I was some sort of a crank. At least now people are taking the whole thing a little bit more seriously, what with the COP summits every year. No, you know, one never knows. Perhaps one year they might actually achieve something.
Yeah. Well, that sure would make a great Hollywood movie, Your Highness. With us Americans coming to the rescue and saving the world, of course. So let's be optimistic. After all, you know what they say? Everything comes to he who waits.
Well, I'm not so sure about that. I mean, look at we, you know. I've been waiting donkey's years, but nothing's changed. Sometimes I think it's never going to happen, and then I get this terrible feeling of gloom and despair.
Oh, come on. Cheer up, Your Highness. These politicians might get around to actually doing something about climate change eventually.
One wasn't talking about climate change. One was talking about Mumsy refusing to abdicate. It is.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to this Labour Party press conference. I'm Sir Keir Starmer, and this is my deputy, Angela Rayner, who would like to read a statement. Wouldn't you, Angela?
Angela can speak for herself, you mansplaining, misogynistic tosser. I mean, thank you, Sir Keir. I'd like to read from a prepared statement. I made a speech recently when I believe I may have described the Tories as scum. I would like to say...
What's that word?
Sorry.
Oh, yes. Sorry. I think Elton John had it spot on when he said it's the hardest word. I do believe it's a first for me. And when I said I wouldn't cross the road to piss on the Prime Minister if he was on fire, that too was a lie. Yeah, I would cross the road, and if he was on fire, I would piss on him. In the spirit of cross-parliamentary cooperation. Yeah. And when I said I wanted to drown the Chancellor in a barrel of brown ale, that too was wrong. For a start, it'd be a waste of good beer. In mitigation, it was budget day and he just put up fags by 63p. So I was obviously a little bit emotional. And as for calling the Tories scum, I have been called much worse. And that's from people in my own party. Anyway, in conclusion, I would like to reiterate my regrets over remarks that I may have made. No matter how true they were. And if any of you got a problem with that, I'll see you out the back of the car park. Right, we're done here.
The Environment Agency has claimed supermarkets could reduce their energy usage by up to 33% by putting doors on their refrigerators. If put in place in time for the next election, this could mean the added bonus of new bog-off offers of buy one Prime Minister, get one free.
Hello, it's me, astronomical sex god Brian Cox. Wow. It's a well-known fact I've run out of things to make a six-part science series about, and I am so bored of the actual universe. You see, most of the universe is nothing to talk about because it contains so much nothing. In fact, the bits of the universe that are not nothing are so mathematically negligible in comparison that the universe is technically nothing. Wow. For decades, I've been answering all the unanswered questions about the universe, and the only ones left to answer are, why do I stand on top of mountains to tell you about stars, planets, meteorites, and black holes? Why do I not age? How do I always manage to stay cheerful? And how can the BBC justify sending me all over the world to point at the same stars that you can see everywhere else? Wow. And the answer is, I don't actually exist in the real universe. I exist in a metaverse. Because if you think about it, a virtual world of 3D models is the only place a scientist that's also a rock god could possibly exist. Wow. Hit it, maestro.
I am quite distraught. I was warm before, but now heating is just something that I can't afford. All at once I find price of gas too high. I can't pay to heat the place where I live. If it starts to freeze in my parlor tank, I'll try keeping warm by snuggling in my eiderdown. Cold I must ignore as gas prices soar. I can't pay to heat the place where I live. And oh, the cowering feeling when it snows or frosts are severe. That overpowering feeling, any second hypothermia is near. Do the Tories care for the likes of me? Gas now costs the earth, I'm in fuel poverty. I don't think they'll mind, they don't care that I can't pay to heat the place where I live. And overpowering feeling when it snows or frosts are severe. And then overpowering feeling Any second hypothermia is near. Do the Tories care for the likes of me? Gas down cost the earth out in fuel poverty. I don't think they'll mind. They won't care that I can't pay to heat the place. I can't pay to heat the place. I can't pay to heat the place where I live.
Brr. What's Scottish for duck? Really? Oh, deep fried, huh?